beloved, I'm so excited this morning once again. So I'm sharing with you the word of resurrection, the mysteries, how God raises us from anything we're going through. It doesn't matter the amount of demons opposed to us. As our Sabbath day ends, there will be a new dawning. A new morning will come in the name of Jesus. I love what Daddy Hagin said years ago. He says, if you are ready and willing to wait on the Lord forever, you will not wait long at all. So long as you are in a hurry, you will delay your breakthrough. So long as you won't let it go, you will postpone your miracle. You should concentrate this week on dying to whatever that's hurting you, dying to whatever that's defeating you, dying to whatever that's discouraging you, dying to whatever that's wounding you. Enter into the Sabbath rest of the Lord. The Bible says in Hebrews 4, those of us that believe do enter into rest. If you believe in resurrection, then let God have the issue. If you believe in resurrection, then let the people gloat. If you believe in resurrection, let the devil mock. Ah, he is coming that bright Sunday morning. Hallelujah. Let's read once again what happened. The Bible says, in the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. And behold, there was a great earthquake. There was a major quaking. Hallelujah. Beloved, when the Holy Spirit begins to move on you, you know you are coming out. When your soul begins to vibrate with the Holy Ghost power, that's your earthquake. He begins to shake all the shakeables. That's why when you're going through difficulties, when you're struggling with sin, when you're struggling with temptations, you spend time in prayer. You spend time in the Word until the power of the Holy Ghost kicks in to cause an earthquake in your life. There is an angel of resurrection carrying the glory of the Father. He came and caused an earthquake. Why? To shake loose that seal they put on the stone. To shake loose every confidence that those soldiers had. To shake loose all their weaponry. Hallelujah. Woo-hoo. May God cause an earthquake to take place that will rob every demon attacking you of their confidence, that will rob them of their weapons, that will remove the seal, that stronghold, and weaken it. So many times I've been besieged by the enemy fiercely, and I will keep praying, and I will call men of faith to pray along. And then all of a sudden, that earthquake will take place. That anointing will hit, and that yoke is broken. Beloved, that is resurrection. That is what happened the day you got saved, as you will find out next week. That's what happened. Without the resurrection, you are still in your sin. No devil could stop you the moment you met God's conditions. And I'm telling you today, beloved, if you meet God's conditions in allowing people to gloat, in entering into that Sabbath rest, your morning is coming. That's why the Bible says, joy cometh in the morning. Joy cometh in the morning. I encourage you to listen to our radio broadcast on Love 860 at 7:45. I preached a powerful mystery, how God reset the Holy of Holies, the throne room, in the tomb of Jesus. You gotta hear it, beloved. It will change your life forever. Hallelujah. Listen to it, beloved. Behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven. Beloved, the Bible said the angel of the Lord encamped around them that fear the Lord. So we are not looking for angels to come from heaven. They're already around us. He says, he came down from heaven and came and rolled back that stone from the door and sat on it. He sat on it to make a point. He sat on it to show them Is this the best you can do? He sat on it to give you and I hope that what seems so impossible, God will make it possible. The Bible says his countenance was like lightning and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let every enemy become as a dead man. Let every stronghold perish. At the voice, at the glory, at the countenance, at the light of the angel of resurrection that God has sent this week to deliver you, to bless you, and to help you and I. I don't know about you. I'm expecting resurrection. I'm expecting glory. I'm expecting victory. Now what the Father did for Jesus, he will do for me. When I cast all my care upon him, when I enter into his rest and wait for resurrection morning. Yes, they will be prancing around. Yes, they have a seal, but it wouldn't matter when the angel shows up. May that angel show up today in your life. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. God bless you. We will conclude tomorrow. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.